Sporting event held in the Adirondacks drew elite cyclists from across the nation. I'm referring to the Whiteface 100K. News Channel 5's Allison Carey was on hand for every moment of this grueling event.
Roughly 450 cyclists from all over North America turned out for the Whiteface 100K. Those who do well enough will qualify for the most prestigious race in off-road and mountain bike riding, Colorado's Leadville Trail 100. The bike fest attracted elite cyclists including David Wines, the sixth consecutive winner of the Leadville Trail, and Billy DeMong, USA's 2010 Olympic gold medalist in Nordic combined skiing.
It's a grueling race. They've got to climb Whiteface Mountain two times, and there are also two 750-meter hills that they've got to climb halfway in between this race. So as much as this race is physical, it's also a pretty mental race as well.
But one person's grueling is another's exhilarating challenge.
This kind of racing is really fun. I was telling him it's like road racing on mountain bikes. So you get a pretty decent group at the beginning, and it slowly gets smaller and smaller. And if you can stay in that group, it's a lot of fun.
Say like about three quarters of the way through, I was like, I'll never do this again. And then the last like 20 minutes, I'm like, this is awesome. I was making plans for next year. So
now this race is not just for racers. We've got lots of friends and family here at Crew Station 1 cheering on the cyclists and also with all the supplies and first aid they might need to make it to the end of the race.
Yeah, we have their water bottles ready. We have rain jackets if they need any repairs from flat tires or broken derailleurs, broken chains. It's all happened before at some point, so we do that here.
From the crew members to the athletes, the Bike Fest is a top-notch competition, and folks in town are proud to see Whiteface emerging as New York's premier cycling destination.
It's kind of a, it's a bit of a secret for a cycling destination, and in our hopes that this race, as well as the Bike Fest that we have, kind of expose Wilmington and Whiteface really as a cycling, not only an off-road cycling destination, but a road cycling destination too. And
now the race came to a soggy finish, but it's not stopping these racers from celebrating. However, they have to be back to the grind on Monday as the Leadville Challenge in Colorado is less than 2 months away. I'm Allison Carey.